Kevin White was formerly a top 10 pick in the 2015 NFL draft, but 5 years later, he is out of the league and he did absolutely nothing. In today's video, we're going to be talking about former West Virginia star wide receiver Kevin White and what happened to his once promising football career. It definitely had nothing to do with skill. This is actually my 100th video on this channel, and I feel like I've come such a long way since I started doing this, so thank you guys for supporting me. If you like college football, then this is definitely the channel for you, and you will not regret subscribing. I need your help to reach 3,000 subscribers by the end of July, and every like, comment, share, and even just staying till the end will help my channel grow. Let me know in the comment section who I should do next, and now let's get started with what happened to Kevin White. Kevin White grew up in the crime-ridden city of Plainfield, New Jersey, with his 6 other brothers and sisters. When he was in middle school, his parents made the tough decision to pack their bags and leave for a safer city with more opportunities for their kids. They first settled on Allentown, Pennsylvania, but it was short-lived as they moved to the nearby city of Emmaus to help their kids achieve their football dreams. As a junior at Emmaus High School, he was buried on the depth chart of the JV team, and his NFL dream was looking bleak. His parents wondered if they had made the right decision. Finally, Kevin caught a break and had a huge breakout senior year, but there was still one major issue: his grades. He blames his academic struggles on his school change because the curriculum was much easier at his previous school. Because of his poor grades, Pittsburgh was the only high major school to offer him, and they decided to back off. He had only received interest from FCS school James Madison. Kevin knew he was talented and decided not to settle for less and not play for FCS football, so he decided to enroll in Lackawanna Community College and ride the JUCO route to FBS football. After impressing the coaches and dominating in practices, Kevin became a starter and had a stellar 2 years at Lackawanna. After redshirting, he missed the financial aid deadline and his football career was in jeopardy once again. His teammate remembers how close Kevin was to quitting and how he wanted to be a social worker or a landlord for college apartments. Fortunately, he got it together and balled out during his time there though. Once again, Kevin was being doubted and not many schools were interested at first. His first few offers were from Hawaii and Bowling Green, but then he caught his big break when he got offers from both Texas Tech and West Virginia. He ended up choosing to be a Mountaineer because of Dana Holgerson's air raid offense and how Morgantown was closer to home. Despite a ton of setbacks, Kevin worked and matured, and he was now a Power 5 football player. Now he just had to prove that he could be consistent and play with the big boys. Going into his junior year at West Virginia, the Mountaineers were under head coach Dana Holgerson, and White was expected to get a chance to play. Led by Florida State transfer quarterback Clint Trickett and running back Charles Sims, the Mountaineers were expected to be pretty solid in 2013. WVU played William & Mary week 1, but Kevin did not see the field. He played his first career game against Oklahoma, and he actually made an impact. At one point in the second half, Kevin caught a pass, made a few guys miss, and he was off to the end zone. But wait, before that could happen, he got hit really hard and lost the ball, and the Sooners would eventually recover the fumble and would win the game. For weeks, he could not let that moment go, and he blamed himself for the loss. I think it affected his play too, as he was a non-factor in their wins over Georgia State and number 11 Oklahoma State. He finally rebounded with a huge 7-catch, 130-yard, and 2-touchdown game in their 73-42 humiliation on the road against number 17 Baylor. From there, they lost back-to-back games to Kansas State and Texas Tech before a huge showdown with TCU. In an absolute thriller, the Mountaineers beat the Horned Frogs with a game-winning field goal in overtime. Unfortunately, that was the last bright spot of the season, as West Virginia lost to Texas, Kansas, and Iowa State in overtime to finish with a 3-9 record. On the year, White caught 35 passes for 507 yards and 5 touchdowns. He became the second best wide receiver on the team, but no one expected he would have the kind of senior campaign he was about to have. Going into the 2014 season, the Mountaineers were going to have a really tough test to open up the year. They opened up as 27-point underdogs against Alabama in the Chick-fil-A kickoff game. In what became a really good matchup, West Virginia and the Tide went down to the wire, but Alabama finished them off late. I clearly remember how good of a game that was, and that afternoon, a new college football star was born. Kevin White caught 9 passes for 143 yards and a touchdown against one of the best defenses in college football. No matter what Alabama did, they couldn't contain Kevin, and most of their teams experienced that for the rest of the year. White continued to tear it up the following week as he caught 10 passes for 101 yards against Towson. He then established himself as a college football superstar when he caught 13 passes for 216 yards and a touchdown against their rival Maryland. Their next matchup was a huge one against number 4 Oklahoma in Morgantown. This would be a chance for Kevin to make up for last year's mistakes against the Sooners, and you could definitely say that he had an impact this game. They ended up losing, but he caught 10 passes for 173 yards and a touchdown on national television. After a bye week, White and the Mountaineers rebounded with a win over Kansas and a 13-catch game in a close win over Texas Tech. Number 4 Baylor came to town the following week, and White had the best game of his career in my opinion. He caught 8 passes for 132 yards and 2 touchdowns in a huge upset win over the number 4 team in the country. After a win over Oklahoma State, the Mountaineers entered the polls for the first time all year for their showdown with number 7 TCU. After one electric play in the beginning, Kevin was a non-factor in the game, but it still went down to the wire. TCU got their revenge from last year and ended up winning 31-30, and West Virginia's Big 12 title hopes were fading pretty quickly. Despite 16 catches from White, they lost on the road to Texas and then at home versus number 12 Kansas State. On senior night, he caught 4 passes in their win over Iowa State, and the Mountaineers would finish the season at 7-5. They were matched up in the Liberty Bowl against Texas A&M, and he caught 7 passes for 129 yards and a touchdown in their one possession loss to the Aggies. Kevin White had become one of the best wide receivers in college football, and he was named to the Big 12's All-First Team, and he was also a consensus second team All-American. He was a finalist for the Biletnikoff Award, and he was considered a lock to become a first-round pick in the 2015 NFL Draft. As a senior, he caught 109 passes for 1,447 yards and 10 touchdowns. In only 2 years at West Virginia, White is 10th all-time in receptions, 3rd in single-season receptions, and 1st in single-game receptions. Plus, he is 2nd in single-season receiving yards and 5th in single-game receiving yards. Going into the 2015 NFL Draft, the top receiver prospect bounced around between Kevin and Alabama wide receiver Amari Cooper. The Raiders were expected to take a wideout, and some mock drafts had him going at the 4th spot. When the actual draft rolled around though, he was taken with the 7th overall pick by the Chicago Bears, and he was expected to turn into their franchise receiver. White came into the Bears organization with a ton of hype and high expectations going into his rookie year. He signed a 4-year, $15 million contract, and he was ready to ball out. Except, that didn't exactly happen. During the offseason, White suffered a small injury in his leg and missed a ton of practices, but it wasn't supposed to be severe, and he was supposed to be ready by the time the season came around. People began to wonder what was going on, and right before the season started, it was announced that he would miss the entirety of the 2015 year with a stress fracture. It was a huge blow to Kevin, who had worked his tail off to this point, only to get injured right when it mattered most. Unfortunately, this was only the beginning of the horrible injury issues though. Kevin was finally healthy and ready to play in the 2016 season, and he was expected to have a huge year. He played his first career game against the Detroit Lions, where he caught 6 passes for 55 yards. Nothing special, but he was targeted 9 times, and he was going to get a ton of chances to prove himself. He caught 6 more passes for a career-high 62 yards against the Cowboys the following week, but he then began to struggle against the Eagles and the Texans before the unthinkable happened. He fractured his fibula in the same leg he hurt the year prior, and he was going to be sidelined for the remainder of the year. So far in 2 seasons, he had only played in 4 games and had still never caught a touchdown pass, but just like Kevin had done his entire life, he bounced back and worked to get healthy again. His work paid off, and he was ready to compete again. He was a starter for them going into the 2017 season, and he caught 2 quick passes in their Week 1 opener against the Cardinals. What I'm about to say just breaks my heart as both a sports fan and as a person. After a catch, he fractured his shoulder blade, exited the game, and was placed on injury reserve for the 3rd straight year. You cannot make this stuff up. I feel so bad for him. Nevertheless, Kevin did not give up, and he was determined to get back on the field and play the game he loved so much and worked so hard for. Going into the 2018 season, the Bears decided they weren't going to pick up White's 5th-year option, so this was really his last chance. He caught 1 pass against both the Jets and the Vikings before he made the only highlight play of his entire career. The Bears were trailing the Patriots and had to go for a Hail Mary to win the game. As time expired, Kevin White caught the Hail Mary pass, but his luck just never seemed to change as he was ruled down at the 1-yard line, meaning it was basically just an irrelevant play, and it showed that he could only get so close before being set back. White was picked up by the Cardinals the following year, but he never really played. For the entirety of his professional football career, Kevin White never caught a touchdown pass and never got to play in more than 4 games in a season. In terms of players who have gotten screwed in terms of injuries, I put Kevin White near the top of the list. He worked so hard just to reach the Division 1 level and to just make something of himself. He was drafted in the top 10 and supposed to be a star, but I guess the football gods just didn't want him to succeed. He never got a chance to show what he could actually do, and he's the complete opposite of a bust in my opinion. It may not have worked out for him in the pros, but he had an incredible college career and is a multi-millionaire, so as long as he is financially smart, he should be set for life. Overall, I really hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and if you did, please be sure to take a moment to smash that like button and show both Kevin and I some love. If you are new, be sure to subscribe to the channel and help me reach 3K subs by the end of July. And while you're at it, check out all my other What Happened To videos. Until next time though, peace.